I'm not gonna waste any of y'all time, bro, man. Yo, it's your boy T-Dog, bro. But look, man, we got toxic T-Dog in the building, man. Look, bro, y'all see the messages, man. This man is coming out my neck, bro. I'm not gonna lie, bro. I got slept, all right? I was in rank, man, having a real bad day. Losing the scrubs, bro. Come across this guy, man, sparks me in 45 seconds. I didn't land a single punch on dude, right? And I left it alone, right? I was like, I'm gonna chalk it up, you know what I'm saying? Today's just ain't my day. I'm taking L's I shouldn't be taking. Y'all know how it goes, right? And this man has the nerve to slide into my messages, bro. Disrespecting me? And we were talking about this first message because I was going, he was choosing GSP and I went to go to GSP to see what his stats were. And then I went to Burns real quick and he thought I was trying to, you know, pull his fast one or something like that, right? Because time was running out. But nah, bro, right? So realistically, I was going to let it slide or whatever, but I was having a bad day and I was like, you know what? Toxic T-Dog's coming out, right? So I responded, you know what I'm saying, with some heat, boy, because I'm like 21 Savage in here, you feel me? I'm not taking disrespect.
I ain't taking disrespect, little nigga. Straight up, put a couple holes in your neck, little nigga. God.
Man, generally I wouldn't give people like this attention, bro. But I was just having a bad day, man. Just kept taking L's, bro. But like this guy, good on him, right? He sparked me in 45 seconds. I didn't land a single punch on this man, but he still felt the need to message me, bro. Like, come on, bro. You got the W, right? So I was like, you know what, bro. You know what? Let me get this rematch, bro. Like, and with a few choice words, a little bit of toxicity. Toxic T-Dog came out. I was able to get that rematch, man. Told him 9 out of 10 fights I beat you, bro. That's what I told him, right? And I would show you guys the clip of me losing, but I don't have it. And I'm not, you know, afraid to post my L's. Y'all know that, right? But I just simply didn't have it, right? So I'm leave you guys with this, and this is pretty much an accurate representation of what happened to me.
Go, Junior. Connor relaxed and smiling. Oh, my! Just slept like that!
As y'all can see, man, I'm not making this up, bro. He has one win over me. Dude's name's Shara09 or something like that. Really a scrub. I was just having an off day. On the off chance that they were really born in 2009, that's tough. But you gotta go, Chief. You ain't gonna disrespect me like that. You know what I mean? That's tough. So here we go. I want y'all to notice something right here, right? Fight starts off. Neither of us go for a glove touch, right? Because we obviously have beef right here, right? So the last fight, he got me against the cage. He kind of spammed switch kicks in a way or whatever, and I just didn't adjust. And then when I tried to adjust, I got clapped, right? It was retarded. So game plan here is just boxing, right? I'm gonna tag this man boxing, right? I wasn't too worried about the body. I was more invested in the head in this one. Right there, boom, look at that. Land a clean head kick, hit him with an ankle pick, because you know, superior grappling in the building. You know what I'm saying? Jiu-jitsu T-Dog in the building, bro. You know what I'm saying? I missed the denial there, but you know, what can you do? I get back, you know what I'm saying? Get backside. So my entire game plan, this entire fight was just overwhelm him, right? Just cut him off, intercept him, get his head health down, right? You know what I mean? Like, I just make him pay, because really, make him eat his words, man. You know what I'm saying? I got smoked. He wasn't lying. I did get, you know, I got your first 45 seconds, right? I just wanted to teach him a lesson, right? Because to me, what's more embarrassing than getting knocked out in the first round is to get destroyed for three rounds and then finished in the last round. You know what I mean? That was my game plan. I didn't want to end it early. I wanted to take my time with man's pause, right? So, you know what I'm saying? He gets some nice shots off here, but he could tell he wanted no part of the ground game. I did not blame him right there. I sidestepped the sidekick right there. I started adding that to my game, some sidesteps, you know, I'm still getting used to it, but, you know, to avoid the straight strikes, it really does help out. Go for that head kick again. He blocks. Look at that. Intercept him right there with that straight uppercut. If you guys have not added that straight uppercut to your arsenal, I highly suggest it, man. One of the best intercepting combos you can throw. I'll say I rely on that heavily, right? Straight uppercuts, it's just a moneymaker, bro, especially when it comes to intercepting people. Look at that. Like I said, trying to spam the switch kick. I'm trying to shut that down right now. Throwing out some slips, just pressure him, stay in his face. And whenever he goes for that straight, whenever he goes for that switch kick, I'm ready for it. You know what I mean? Ready to block it. Crown him, right? Goes for an axe kick right there, you know, whatever, another switch kick. I'm not worried about the switch kicks because I have a plan, right? I'm just going to stick to the game plan, not get overzealous, right? See, part of the last fight right there is I caught his switch kick and he hit me with the flying knee. And then that's my kryptonite, man. I always forget about that, right? I always get hit by that flying knee, so I was careful then. I get the rock, man. This guy's shit has been out of the freaking grass! You see what I'm saying, bro? It's like, sit down! Sit down! Smoke me now! You know what I'm saying, bro? Like, come on! Get up! Right? It's like, bro, you've been talking all that look at, I almost finished him right there, bro. Nigga, he's trash. He's literally pancakes, bro. This dude's dog water, bro. You know, it's like he just hopped on the game, bro. I really lost to this dude. This dude has three combos, dude. Look at that. So that's nice sidekick to the body. I give him that one, right? Goes for a head kick to a straight. Stop that. Intercept it!
Was it deep down the middle? Intercept it!
Yes!
Get up! Right? I was like, get up, bro. Like, you're not going to talk all that. He denies the stat guard there, bro. It's just, I just wasn't in the mood to be played with this game, right? I wasn't in a rush. I wouldn't even say I was anxious to get a finish. I was just trying to... I'm trying not to curse, man. I was just trying to really deal with man's, right? Dude's literally pancakes. Look at him just eating that shin to the head, man. You know what I'm saying? My man's, I eat, sleep, and breathe head kicks, bro. You know what I'm saying? You give me that opening, bro. You're going to get clapped.
Simply up, like, put close attention to bro, right? Nine. Round's over. He watches the replays. He's over there mourning. You know what I'm saying? Because he knows he lost. You know, he messed up. He tries to touch my glove, bro. Y'all notice how in the first round, y'all saw the difference? In the first round, he came up and he didn't want a part of it. But then right there, he tried to touch my glove, bro. You see the difference, how people's attitude changes when, you know what I mean, when they meet their maker, bro? It's like, come on, man. If you're going to talk like that, bro, keep that same energy. Get rocked, you know, two of the body, one of the head, right? Switch kick, give him a little taste of his own medicine, bro. I'm not here for the games, bro. Honestly, I was in it. Look at it. Get dropped! Get up! Realistically, bro, like, come on, man. You're not gonna talk all that then come in here and try to touch my glove. I'm with a head kick there. I was trying to catch him coming in. That was the money shot, right? You know. Now, I'm not gonna lie here. I got a little overzealous here, right? I got a little tag. He's up against the cage. Good on him right here. Give him that, right? I wanted to finish in this round, to be honest. Watching back now, I could tell I really wanted to finish in this round. But I did a good job of not getting too crazy. He kept going for that head kick. I tried to return the favor. I should have invested a little more into the body now that I think about it, actually, though. But yeah, tag him there. Two to the body, one to the head again. Switch kick again to the same thing because I'm trying to condition him. Hits me with this another spinning back kick to the body. Got to address that. Catch him going for a leg kick, and he gets sat down again. You see how that happens, bro? You see how it happens when you talk, bro? Nice front kick, whatever, right? See, my thing is, right, man's kicking me when I'm down, and then he has the nerves, bro. Has the nerves to try to touch my glove, bro. Like, imagine that, right? Imagine that, bro. He has me against the cage, 1-2 head kick, but I'm trusting my block. I'm not trying to do anything stupid, right? He catches me there. Yeah, router, 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 right? I don't do anything crazy. You don't do anything crazy. Try not to get finished there. Do a good job of avoiding getting dropped because, you know, you get dropped one time, the ground and pound. He shoots a takedown. Now, I had no intention of blocking low there because I'm not worried about the takedown, right? I was trying to exchange. I was trying to draw the exchanges because his head was lower than mine. I get the rubber guard there. I wait a second and I try to go to side control, but he gets the stat guard. But keep in mind, I'm not worried about this man's ground game at all. I'm Gilbert Burns. I know I'm very capable of, you know, defending myself as I get my face smashed right there. And, you know, he gets a rock there. But anyway, he gets off me. Like, I can tell he wants the grappling because he knows the striking isn't working, but he's not going to get anywhere with the grappling, right? So I could tell I was completely fine with that, right? He does the 1-2 head kick again. So he's fishing for that. So I note that, but look at that. Gets another takedown. I have no intention. So look, I had a feeling he was either going to go for a fake or a pre-deny rubber guard. So I just went up there and got that free transition right there. I was, I guess, correct, and I was right. So here I am on top now. This guy, honestly, he had no intention. So as you can tell, the clock's running down. So I try to go up here and get some damage right here. Now, keep in mind, even when you're an angry man or, you know, you're passionate about the fight, look at that. He gets that nice. You got to play with some IQ, right? So right here, look at the rounds running out. So instead of letting him posture up and get some damage, I go up, right? And instead of trying to deny the takedown, I hold R2 because, you know, of course, there's only a few seconds left. Of course, he's going to go for the knee to the head to try to get some damage, right? The takedown wouldn't do him any favors, right? You know what I mean? So even if you're having a bad day, things like that, man. Because what if I would have messed up, right? And, you know, tried to block takedown and got hit with a knee and a rock or something like that. And they could have, you know, spiraled in the next round. You never know, man. So you got to play it as smart as possible, man. You got to play it as smart as possible. So what I didn't understand, right? Dude's over here watching the replays of him getting just destroyed, man. Like, honestly, I think he was surprised. I think when you beat someone in the first round, in like the first, you know, minute, you don't really get a feel of how they play or, like, you know what I mean, of how good they are. So I'm not saying that I'm great or anything, but you know what I mean. So he's relying heavy on that one. He's just trying to break my block, right? I sidestep that, get a 1-2, with a straight hook uppercut. I mean, you know what I mean, jab hook uppercut, drop on him. He gets the up kick. He kept doing that, but keep in mind, the sidesteps, the slips, that was just money for me, especially intercepts. Catch him with another head kick on the way in. I'm just not here to play, bro. It's honestly, man, I knew this round was a round for me to get him out of here. But I do have to say, I did get overzealous this round. I made a few mistakes that I need to, you know, clean that up on. Granted, keep in mind, I was fresh off of losing this guy in 45 seconds. This was like minutes afterwards, and I was not happy. So I'm actually surprised I played as good as I did. He catched me with the 1-2. I tried to exchange 1-2s. He got there first. Spams the switch kick to the body. Well, doubles up on it. I wouldn't say spam, but considering the amount of times he's done it, you know what I mean. So over here, sticking to the boxing. I'm not avoiding, you know, I'm not shying away from the game plan at all. I got rocked. I'm still going to follow the game. Look, intercept them again. Another up kick. Dude's getting bailed out, right? 1-2. I duck it. He didn't read that, though. So, look, I had a feeling he wouldn't, you know, he would continue trying to, because he was camping on that 1-2 head kick. I duck again. He could have thrown an uppercut, but I had a feeling it wasn't right here. Look at, get knocked out! Oh bitch! I was just trying to, I'm trying not to curse. Sorry. I still have that happen sometimes. Then he has the nerve to message me. Good fight, bro. Get clapped, bro. Honestly, y'all might be saying, T-Dog, you didn't show any respect to this guy. Did you read the messages, bro? Like, why would I show respect to this man? He only showed respect after he got bested, right? He didn't show me any respect. He kicked me when I was down, man. You know what I mean? See, that shows this dude's character. Look at the dude's attitude, how he switched after I beat him. Went from this to this to this. Think about it, man. First of all, don't kick someone when they're down. Second of all, if you're gonna be disrespectful like that, man, and come at someone's neck after you already beat them, keep that same energy, bro. Don't switch up just because they beat you, bro, honestly. If you like this video, man, leave a like, of course. Subscribe, comment, let me know what y'all thought. Let me know if you want more content like this, which I wanna see next. But yeah, appreciate y'all, young boys, man. Peace.